This video is a description of the Beer-Lambert Extinction Law, which is a mathematical quantification of how light availability changes as you move from the top of a forest canopy to the forest floor. This equation can be used to describe light availability at any point within a forest canopy. So the Beer-Lambert Extinction Law really quantifies this process described here. So on its way through the canopy, light passes through successive layers, and light intensity decreases as it encounters those layers because those layers of leaves absorb light. This decrease is almost exponential as cover increases. And a couple of Japanese researchers, a couple of Japanese forest ecologists, Mansi and Saiki, described this with the following extinction equation. So on the left-hand side is a term that basically describes how much light is transmitted at any given depth from the top of the canopy. And this is described as the light intensity at depth Z, so that's your focal depth, divided by the light intensity or the light that's incident on the top of the canopy. So this is basically how much of the light coming in the canopy is transmitted to the depth of interest. Now this light availability at this point in the forest is an exponential function described by this equation, E, which equals 2.718. It's a mathematical term, raised to the minus k, where k is the extinction coefficient for the plant community. So this is a negative exponential curve, and k describes is one of the parameters describing the shape of that exponential decay. And then the other parameter is LAI, the leaf area index at the level that light intensity is being measured. So what does LAI mean? LAI is basically quantified as the total leaf area as a function of the total ground area. So you take a fixed ground area, say 1 meter squared, and then you quantify how much leaf area is above that 1 meter squared. So one way to do this would be to harvest all of the biomass above that 1 meter square and measure the leaf area of all of it. And that leaf area divided by that ground area gives you a leaf area index. If you take a look at this figure on here, we have, if you have the same ground area, you're comparing the same ground area, the plant that has more foliage is going to have a higher LAI than the plant that has less foliage. What are average foliage or forest LAI values across the globe? Well, tropical rainforest and temperate deciduous forests actually have fairly similar LAIs. And this is averaged across kind of the closed canopy and gappy aspects of it. So this is an overall average for these forest types. They range from 4 to 7 or 8. Temperate evergreen forests, so these are the temperate rainforests of the Pacific Northwest in the U.S., for example, tend to have higher LAIs than tropical rainforests or temperate deciduous forests. And savanna is the focus of what we have been kind of thinking about quite a bit in the class up till now, have lower leaf area indices, as you might expect, given that they have lower density of trees across a given area of land. So in general, the rule of thumb is more leaves equals higher LAI. So what about K? So K is the extinction coefficient for the plant community. It's a term that really characterizes how rapidly or how slowly light levels decline as you move from the top of the forest canopy to the forest floor. So this is kind of a term that says, do you decline in light really fast as you start going down through the canopy, or is this more of a slower process? Does light penetrate more deeply into the forest or less deeply into the forest? Extinction coefficients vary quite a bit. low extinction coefficients occur in things like white spruce, a little bit higher in red pine, 0.4. Trembling aspen are similar to red pine, to a little bit higher. And then a beech forest, in this case, in this comparison, has the highest K, 0.6 to 0.65. And so low values like the white spruce indicate slow decline of light with the depth in forest. And if you think about the structure of a white spruce crown, this is kind of a triangular shaped crown. You can imagine that from the top of a canopy of many white spruces together, you might imagine that most of the leaf area is lower in the canopy, so there's not as much leaf area at the top of the canopy. And that means that light declines slowly as you move from the top to the floor. In contrast, high values like the beech forest indicate rapid decline of light with depth. In a beech forest, lots of leaves, horizontally oriented, tend to be towards the top of the canopy. So a lot of light is intercepted right away, leading to rapid decline. So I know some of you, many of you are visual learners, so let's take a look at what this equation looks like in a graphical picture. So here's a graph that shows three different K values and the light transmittance across a range of LAIs. So across the x-axis, we have leaf area index going from low, meaning few leaves, to lots of leaves. You can imagine this as a low LAI forest versus a high LAI forest, or you can imagine it as moving from the top of the canopy where there's no leaves above the point you're measuring down into the canopy. And as you get deeper and deeper, there are more and more leaves above your light sensor. Along the y-axis, we have the percent light transmitted. So that is light that we see at a particular depth as a ratio of that incident at the top. And this is multiplied by 100 just to give us a percentage. So with an LAI of zero, there's no leaves, there's no interception, you have 100% of the light is transmitted from, say, one layer to the next. What you see here is where you have a low, small k, you have a fairly shallow slope. And at any given LAI with a low k, you have more light availability than a medium or a high k. Let's look at this high k. What you see is that with a high k value, an LAI of 1 leads to a quite dramatic decline of light availability. So rapid decline of light availability when you have a higher K. In all of these, as LAI increases, light availability decreases. So there's kind of two trends here. The fact that LAI, as it increases, light declines. You have less light coming in, but how much light is attenuated, or light is transmitted, the opposite of that, of attenuated, really depends on the K of that forest. K is related to the clumping, the distribution, the angle of the leaves. And it, as I said, influences light transmission at any particular LAI value. So the take-home message related to the Beer-Lambert Extinction Law, and in general forest structure and light availability, is that whatever blocks light reduces transmittance towards the forest floor. So more leaves, there's more opportunity to block light. And if those leaves are more evenly spread, there's less clumping, there's fewer spaces between branches, the leaves are horizontal or kind of a random or more variable orientation of leaf angles, you have less opportunity for light to pass through. And that's important. because LAI and light extinction play a really important role in terms of thinking about forest productivity. So this is a graph from a whole range of different forests that differ in their LAI. So we're just looking at one of these factors here. But and what you see is that as LAI increases, ANPP, which is basically a measure of productivity, and we're going to cover this later in class, increases. So the productivity of your forest, how productive, how much mass you put on in a given year, is strongly related to your leaf area. And that should make sense to all of you, given that leaves are the powerhouses of the trees. That's where photosynthesis occurs. The more leaves you have, the more photosynthesis you can have, the more carbon you can gain, the more productive you are as a tree or as a forest.